living wall is basically a garden that is installed vertically on a wall. It's a fifth term project that the students are working on.
We have three teams. We have the structural team, the bioarts team, and the tech team.
I have four students who are responsible for the aesthetic and the kind of biological part.
So we each sketched a design towards the beginning.
Once we had our final blueprints drawn out, we went around the school and took like a poll, and we had the students choose their favorite design.
These are going to be the base plants because they're the really small ones. And then this is a Japanese shield fern, and this is a red Fichtonia, and those are the ones we're probably keeping.
The structural team who you see behind me was responsible for actually building the physical structure of the wall and the irrigation system, so all the stuff that goes on behind the scenes.
We have two layers of felt here, and they're very thick, and that'll act as the soil for the plants. So when we cut a hole in here, we make a little pouch. That's where the roots of the plant will go, and they'll grow in there. And the entire felt will be wet from the irrigation system. That'll keep the plants moist and happy.
Use the skin of your stuff. And then I have two students who are working on the life support system.
Basically, we're in charge of making the wall self-sufficient. So there's a couple different monitors and sensors that we have to build. So like this one is the moisture sensor, which is probably the most important, so the plants don't die. And there's also the light sensor and temperature sensors, which will be added on later.
The deadline's really soon, and we're ordering over 300 plants for the wall. So there, our plants right now are actually coming up from Florida on a truck.
The sensors are the thing that I'm still not totally sure if it's gonna work quite right.
We're basically just putting all the plants in. We have to take a bit of the soil off from the bottom and slash in pockets here, like this one right here. And then we just insert the plant with a little bit of soil, and we staple them. And we're just trying to fill in the spots according to the blueprint.
This is just gonna be a really great project that's gonna stay on forever for Avenues, hopefully.
After mounting the plywood, we place the waterproof membrane over it. It stops any water from seeping through the structure.
Our task included researching the sensors we would have to later make, code, and set up. This was all entirely new to me, so I had to conduct extra research just to simply understand the basis of programming and coding.
We use the analog pins on the Arduino, and what they do is basically they detect the voltage from 0 to 5 and then turn them into an integer number from 0 to 1023.
One of the things that was really important for this project in terms of making it a really authentic real-world experience was that there's a genuine audience here. It's the students, it's their peers, it's their teachers. We tried to get the whole community involved in sponsoring different plants, and everyone on this team comes in and works hard every day because they know that the entire school is looking forward to this project and really has a stake in it coming out well.